big things expected of both Arsenal and Aston Villa in the WSL this season. Neither team have lived up to expectations, but can an energised Emirates help the Gunners ignite their season? Or will Aston Villa get their campaign up and running at Arsenal's expense today?
Curtis cross and in! Liverpool leads! A dagger in Arsenal hearts.
This is promising. Daly, good first touch! Oh! And it's Rachel Williams! Heartbreak for Aston Villa.
Lucas to surely snatch a point for Arsenal.
A roll and a finish. Aston Villa, back-to-back defeats for them.
You have to go back to 2014 for the last time Arsenal failed to win their opening three matches. Well, will a last-minute Lacazette equaliser against Manchester United last weekend be enough to inspire this ever-changing Arsenal lineup? Aston Villa's fifth-spot finish last season was their best ever, but with two losses in two, they're going to need to refine some of that form if they want to turn things around. Carlo Ward's side are still without injured midfielder Ken Zardali and suspended Kirsty Hansen. It's Arsenal versus Aston Villa live from the Emirates Stadium, and kickoff is in 10 minutes' time. A big welcome to my guests today, Anita Asante and Gilly Flaherty. Thank you for joining me. Look, it's a huge game here for Arsenal today, Anita. Out of the Champions League, they're yet to win in the WSL. Goalkeeper issues. How does Jonas go about steadying the ship today?
Well, I think today it's really important to get your more experienced players back on the pitch in this team, commanding, especially when errors and mistakes happened, as we saw D'Angelo in their last game. They didn't really recover, you know, from those situations. And I think Russo as well, she starts down the centre. That will be really important to have that focal point for the team.
Yeah, I suppose Arsenal's opponents today, Aston Villa. Gilly, they wore the best of the rest hat last season, but it hasn't really clicked for them so far. Why is that?
I think one of the players that they're missing who's been key to them is Ken Zardali. You know, me and Neat's just talking about it. The link-up play with Rachel Daly, they combine so well. So not having her available, not having Hansen available as well. But they've had difficult games. I felt against United, they was unlucky not to get a result. Liverpool played really well last week. Villa had an off game. So it's a big game today for them.
Yeah, well, Carla Ward actually said about that loss to Liverpool last weekend, it was her team's worst performance she has seen. And actually, it was a reality check. Let's get her thoughts ahead of this one. Both managers have been speaking to Jeanette Quache.
The girls have been excellent. And I think, you know, we have to put into context those opening two games. So, look, we know that we had a really, really tough start. We know this is going to be even tougher. So, but we will be prepared for it. This group, we talk a lot about character. They've reacted this week. They've been sensational. So, yeah, look, what we want today is an honest performance. And I think we'll get that.
It's Beth Mead back on the bench. How happy are you to see her back?
Of course, really important for the team. Really important for her. A lot of hard work behind the scenes has led her now to this moment, and really pleased for that. And we'll see if she can also make an impact from the bench today.
Yeah, Beth Mead back on the bench for Arsenal. Haven't seen her since November 2022 against Manchester United. That was the game she got injured. How big will it be, her return to the team, Gilly?
Oh, it'll be huge. You know, the presence that Beth has. You know, she's a game changer. She offers them so much in the wide areas. But I'm glad that she's been introduced slowly back. You know, there could have been times in previous games where they could have been desperate and chucked her on. But I think coming back from an ACL, the recovery is key and managing those minutes. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we do see her on the pitch today, though.
And the fans here, Anita, I bet they will not be waiting to see her back, the reception that she will get.
Oh, it's going to be immense, I think, for her as well. Probably an emotional but an amazing feeling to be back with her team, especially at a time where they're really trying to get those results. It's a massive boost for them.
Yeah, what do Aston Villa do here today?
Well, I think Aston Villa today need to just be dogged in everything they do, work hard as a team, make sure they get some good link-up play with Rachel Daly, put her into good positions to attack.
Okay, well, this is going to be a good match, a big match for both teams here. Let's get you up to our commentary team. Rachel Brown-Finnis is alongside Robin Cowan.
Thank you, Alex. Good afternoon, everyone. Only the third round of matches in the WSL season, but already a game of high stakes. Two sides have been tipped for success, but have made slow starts to the new campaign. Arsenal have just 1 point from their opening two fixtures, while Aston Villa are still yet to get off the mark. The pressure mounting, you can smell the jeopardy in the air in North London. It's 5 changes from the Arsenal side that drew the Manchester United. Manuel Zinsberger returns in goal. It's a back four with Lotta Wubben-Moy in place of Jen Beattie. Frida Marnham starts, while Katie McCabe makes her 200th appearance for Arsenal. Caitlin Ford draws up her century. They both join the front line in support of Alessia Russo. And Beth Mead is named on the bench in the WSL for the first time since suffering her ACL injury in November last year. 3 changes from the defeat to Liverpool for Villa. Simone McGill starts for the first time in the WSL after a serious knee injury during the Euros last summer. Laura Blinkiller-Brown also returns for former Arsenal midfielder Jordan Nobbs, who drops to the bench. Mas Pacheco is fit to start and comes into the back line. Kenta Dali is still out with injury, and Kirsty Hansen is serving the second game of her 3-match suspension. I'm Rachel Brown-Finnis. Your players to watch, and you're looking at the forward line for both sides today.
Yes, Alessia Russo obviously making that move from Manchester United to Arsenal is going to be key in getting Arsenal's season going, and will be a real test for Daphne van Domselaar in the goal. Looking forward to seeing both goalkeepers as well. And for Aston Villa, the counterpart, the other number 9, Rachel Daly. England teammates Alessia Russo and Rachel Daly. Daly top scorer last season. Was that spearhead of attack has been hampered somewhat with the lack of Kenza Dali and the Dali-Daly link-ups we got used to last season. But again, set pieces, live play, she's key to everything positive that Villa do.
And before kick-off, we will observe a moment's silence for the innocent victims of the devastating events in Israel and Palestine. Our thoughts are with those around the world who are feeling the effects. Aston Villa won the last meeting between these two, the final game of last season when Arsenal had already secured Champions League football, but not for long. They're already out and they just have 1 point from their opening 2 games. This means a lot. There's going to be Aston Villa in their change strip, all in blue. will get us underway, but not before both sets of players take the knee. Here we go, Rachel Daly gets the ball rolling. On match day 3 of the Women's Super League. Aston Villa, they were unfortunate in their opening game against Manchester United. Carla Ward pulled no punches when describing their performance against Liverpool. And a new shape today, Rachel Brown finish. Just a little illustration of how they're trying to get to grips with the new expectation of this new season for Villa.
You're right, because the first season was about survival in the WSL, and then last season they were excellent. Key signing of Rachel Daly, of course, among others. So then it's about settling the ship, really, and she's not been happy with the level of performances, and rightly so, Carla Ward.
Free kick given by Amy Fearn, the referee. I think it will be notable that you won't see too many complaints coming from players. They have been warned. Two sets of fixtures we've already had, and a record number of yellow cards and red cards at this stage of a WSL season.
No pun intended, but yeah, there's no argument with the dissent law. I agree, that's how it should be. Just get on with the game.
Here is Catley, on to Frieda Mornham, delivers low. The clearance is straight back to her. The loose pass, doesn't find Ford. Villa playing with a slightly more sturdy three at the back. That's the hope anyway. It's given away in a dangerous area to the dangerous Katie McCabe. Here's Valti and now Kim Little.
Both teams really will be looking to use this game to spearhead their season. Neither have started as they would have wanted to. You want to say it about making lots of change to this game 5, to the starting lineup. Carla Ward, not happy with performance the opening couple of games.
Ford skipping away from the challenge of Mailing, forced inside. Little. Shot on the turn from McCabe, didn't quite get hold of it. The first effort on target for the Gunners.
Yeah, with Katie McCabe starting out on that right-hand side, what she'd be looking to do is exactly what she did, cut in centrally and open it up for that wand of a left foot we know she has.
Lovely touch from Daly. Finds Mailing, then Killer Brown, that's a lovely touch as well. This is promising from Villa. Simone McGill stopped in her tracks. Arsenal neatly get back control.
It's a build-up play through the centre for Villa. Just looking down this near side to us. Catley and Ford combination back for the first time this season starting for Arsenal. All Gunners will be excited to see that.
Staniforth.
She'll want some consistent run of games, won't she, starting in the centre of that midfield. Jordan Nobbs on the bench today, so her partnership, well, that partnership broken up just a little late there. Good experience from Amy Fearn being shown there. The referee.
Onto Woodman-Moy. Onto Catley. Caitlin Ford collects and completes the nutmeg, although the assistant referee has indicated a throw for Villa. Did just stray out of play, but just a demonstration of her technical ability, Caitlin Ford.
I'm excited to see Daphne van Domselaar in goal, the Dutch goalkeeper. First time watching her live this season.
Here's Mornham. Centred towards Russo, but Horsey got there first.
There's Van Domselaar, the Dutch number one. Key signing for Carla Ward, really clever signing. The loss of Han Hampton, gone to Chelsea, who was starting number one for Aston Villa last season. Don't want to be rotating your goalkeepers.
Seems to be very much an Arsenal thing.
Coincidence or otherwise, I'm not sure it's worked out for either the men's or the women's team.
Sabrina D'Angelo with a high-profile error, the draw against Manchester United. Dinsberger back in. Seems there is no number one shirt, apart from the one that Dinsberger is actually wearing. Here's Anna Patton, another former Arsenal player.
Yeah, Anna Patton and Wubba Mooi came through the academy together, went to America at the same time, youth internationals together.
Kept in by Catley, Australian international. Forced off and out by Rachel Daly. Is Parker. Good challenge from Russo. Now she has to get her head down and get up the pitch. McCabe trying to help it on to Kim Little. Wasn't really an option out on the far side. Here's Maz Pacheco for Villa.
Yeah, Maz Pacheco sit flat as a five when Villa are out of possession, but should be required to do some mileage up and down that left-hand flank.
Russo. Alia Valti. Al Maritz. It's been the one position where they're a little light, Arsenal, the right side of defence. No real replacement for Noel Maritz. Is the Swiss international back to Kim Little.
Arsenal fans will be enjoying how Arsenal set out, very attacking with Mornham just in behind Russo central, Ford on the left and Kate McCabe on the right. Always want to see Katie McCabe on the team sheet if you're an Arsenal fan, wherever that might be.
On the team sheet and usually in the referee's book as well. The most booked player in the WSL last season, and she's already got 2-2. So a fiery character.
Yeah, only needs half an hour coming off the bench in the last game to get the yellow, but that's what she's about, an impassioned player. Player who wears that armband with absolute pride.
Also tried to flick it towards Mornham, but it's back in Villa possession. They've looked confident in tight situations so far. Van Domselaar in bright sunshine.
We've watched games here before, similar time of day, and that'll be the position for the Arsenal goalkeeper second half. I think that sunshine will go. Arsenal did warm up in Aston Villa's half and decided to change ends because of the sunshine, so maybe they know meteorology better than I do.
No foul on Daly. Here's Caitlin Ford. Showed a bit too much of that to Patton, who got a foot in. Here's Blinkiller Brown. Back-to-back WSL games at the Emirates for Arsenal. They broke the attendance record on the opening day. A disappointing result against Liverpool, but 54,000 fans to see it. Here's Ford. Again, Aston Villa continue to try and play out.
Going back to the record-breaking crowd. So for so many years, Arsenal have been the blueprint of teams. Look back in the 90s, winning everything, the 2000s, winning FA Cups galore, being the team to beat. Met Faye White in the car park downstairs, captain, very proud captain of a very successful Arsenal team. So to be, have the club have always been behind Arsenal, to show that with a record-breaking crowd, I think it's very fitting. The crowd want a performance, so.
Referee saw the foul on Alessio Russo, but Arsenal have the ball and they have the momentum. Here's Mornham. Villa back in a good shape. Now Catley to her Australian teammate, Caitlin Ford. Who's on the outside this time. It's an awkward one for Van Domselaar. Couldn't hold it. And Maz Pacheco made the clearance just a yard off the goal line.
Oh, Van Domselaar made a mess of that one. Great work from Caitlin Ford, exactly what she's about. Gets a little nick off the defender and it's dipping down and goes under Domselaar.
Pacheco in the right place. Is a foul. A free kick for Aston Villa.
Pressure relief there for Villa. Edgy time for Van Domselaar. Gets a little deflection here and you see the ball dipping down and that's just what she doesn't judge perfectly, Van Domselaar. Aston Villa very fortunate. But that's not a simple tap-in for an Arsenal player.
She doesn't look like she's shielding her eyes or anything, but did you ever partake in a cap?
I can't believe you just said the word cap. Caps are gone. No, the sunshine, you've got your cap on, you can only see sort of 10 feet and above. No point.
Panama hat, straw hat.
I actually had some contact lenses that were kind of like, had a sunglass effect. So they were the best solution to direct sunshine. We don't tend to have too many match days where sunshine's a problem in this country.
Well, that cheer you heard was Beth Mead warming up for the first time. And it might get louder as Arsenal, again, trying to carve out an opportunity. Here's Valti and now Kim Little.
Villa do so well to congest that central area. You saw Kim Little just looking then. Who can she thread the ball to? So condensed.
Little. Here's Maritz. Now McCabe. Little fires it to Ford. First time ball in towards Russo. It's a good idea, but she was well marshalled there by the defender. Here's Mornham, not too many options in the middle. Corner kick.
It's been all Arsenal. I just had a look at Rach Daly and her body language is a little dejected. I'm not sure she's even touched the ball yet in this game. Arsenal are knocking on the door. Van Domselaar needs to shore things up. Be brave.
To Mornham, the deep corner, and there's a couple of players down.
It's Valti who's remonstrating, she's been grabbed around the neck. Even Rachel Corsi holding Ruben Moy, Sarah Mailing. And Valti, can't see anything clear there. Arsenal and Jonas Eidevall, who's just got up off his bench, desperate for some return from a dominant first 15 minutes.
Come back, the dogged Katie McCabe. She also has an extremely dangerous left foot. Walty, that's a fantastic ball. Is it going to be kept in? Flag stayed down. And Villa making a bit of meal of trying to clear this. It's teed up. McCabe might get a second bite here.
Danger, danger. Great run down that right-hand side. Phenomenal ball from Valti. You see there, she looks up, she sees the space. Just stretching forward. Does really well to cut it back. Again, Van Domselaar, I think, should have cut that off at the near post. There's no other place that play can go when they reach the touchline. Cutting it back's the only option. Have to anticipate that. Game's on a knife edge. So want to get on with it. Dominated all the possession. The only thing they haven't done is the ball in the back of the net.
It's a bit short from Valti. Blinkiller Brown trying to pick out Daly, but Ruben Moy steps in and creates some space as well. Finds Ford. Arsenal currently on a four-match winless run stretching back to last season in the WSL. They have never gone five games without a win in this competition. Was given a three-year contract announced a couple of weeks ago, so they believe in him, but still, pressure is on.
Yep, well-documented serious injuries. Beth Mead, Weinreuter, Miedemar, Leah Williamson. Key players. But you've got to address why. Why has that happened? All in the last year. I know they've got a full-time nutritionist for the first ever time. They've brought in three full-time recruitment members of staff. So I think those foundations behind the scenes have been bolstered.
Here's Valti, now Little. Arsenal in control, but nothing to show for it so far. Maritz, intelligent run there from Russo, pulling out wide, trying to create the space, but instead wins a corner.
Two key players, Kim Little and Leah Valti, sat in front of the back four for Arsenal. So much experience, feeding the likes of Russo, who's drifting out wide. Take the corner quickly.
It's cleverly done. And the cave goes down. On first viewing, it looked like a well-timed challenge. Let's have a look.
Yeah, when it's a striker who has made that challenge, and having played with Simone McGill, like most strikers, it's not their strongest point. Just about gets enough of the ball. And I do think that McCabe knocked the ball onto McCabe's foot, and therefore McCabe didn't make much of it, to be fair. But would VAR have overturned that?
Oh.
Thankfully, we'll never know.
Well said. Something we don't have to worry about today. Forward, away from Mailing. And Daly showing a little frustration there as that ball failed to reach her. Here's McCabe. Now Little. Sharp turn and the threaded pass, but Staniforth did well to track that. Little wins it back.
Kelly Ford on this near touchline, she's stretching the play. She knows that that's how Arsenal are going to find the gaps by keeping the width, switching it. Here comes Aubameyang. Stretch out the back line, because that's where Aston Villa are defending excellently well. He's central. Look at those numbers around the ball.
Here's Caitlin Ford. Flag is up.
Oh, well.
Not offside.
Given to Villa.
Carlo Ward would be very happy from an out of possession point of view. What are Aston Villa doing to stop Arsenal playing in possession? So far, not much to go on.
Stanford into Parker into space. Mailing delivers, and that's really good defending from Ruben Moy. Here goes Lessie Russo, needing a bit of support. Already hearing her name chanted by supporters of her new club. She has scored here at the Emirates for Manchester United in that dramatic 3-2 win over Arsenal in the WSL last season. Yet to get off the mark in the league, at least, for the Gunners. A couple in the Champions League qualifiers.
Certainly that partnership that we saw to great effect from Manchester United of Ella Toon and Alessia Russo hasn't not got anything similar yet for Arsenal. Through Mornham, who's played predominantly in behind Russo. Final pass in the box has just not been crisp enough for Arsenal.
Challenge on Lucy Parker. The word for Frieda Mornham.
A lovely little bit of footwork, wasn't it, from Lucy Parker? Playing defence or midfield. Lovely little check. Chop to her right and left just to see Seth Catley.
Pacheco, quite slip it through for Simone McGill, it's kept in. Staniforth. Mailing. It's good front foot play from Sarah Mailing. Delicate touch from Rachel Daly. Zinsberger has come, but Kim Nicol didn't want to take any chances, and it's a first corner of the game for Aston Villa.
Really good work from Simone McGill. The ball was fired into her. No wrist football from Kim Little in her defensive duties. There in the armband. He's done for many, many years. Flick on there, ends up going to Simone McGill. Just rushes Kim Little into a clearance, and Villa's second corner of the game.
Staniforth delivers. Oh, Pacheco! Villa in front! It's a towering header! First corner of the game, and it results in the first goal of the game. Arsenal behind again. And Mas Pacheco has just her second WSL goal in her career. It's our first in September 2016. It was worth the wait.
I think she was as delighted as everyone else was, or certainly, wow, what a goal. I mean, just completely unmarked. Everything negative about Arsenal this season has been about defensively. Ilicic just completely misses her header. Mas Pacheco is in acres of space. Who was supposed to be marking her, because she was a completely uncontested header. It was so close in that Leah Valti on the line cannot react in time to stick anything out. And Carla Ward probably preempted they would concede possession to Villa, but they get their chance on set pieces, and that's exactly what they've done.
And now, just like on the opening day of the season here at the Emirates, Arsenal's opponents have something to hold on to. They might want more. Daly onto McGill. Just about keeps that in. Blue shirts flooding forward. Parker's there. Well defended, though. Ilicic got ahead to it for Arsenal. Here's Mailing. And now Parker. Confidence high. Daly! A fairly easy one for the goalkeeper, but that goal has just upped the tempo for Villa.
Yeah, lovely little ball in from Lucy Parker. Really difficult for Rach Daly coming back away from goal to generate the power to Tess Insberger. Right, Aston Villa have just moved up the pitch, haven't they? Just keep the ball in their attacking third. They've soaked up so much pressure defensively.
For all of Arsenal's possession, for their control. Van Domselaar has had one slightly nervy moment, but apart from that, it's been plain sailing. Here's Russo.
No saves to make for Van Domselaar, other than one little P-roller from McCabe. Final third, no real polish. Clinical, Mead and Vivian Miedemark playing in those attacking roles have been in the past. And then defensively, Lee Williamson, Raffaele, neither of them here today as centre-halves, and Arsenal are suffering because of that.
Little. And they've switched it up. Started with three at the back in their previous two WSL games. Hedlai, Kadena, now a new central defensive partnership in Ilicic and Wubbenboy today. Trying to get those relationships going. And the WSL is difficult, they don't have a lot of time.
Two new teammates, two new players to the WSL. Throw in the fact that he's mixed up Sabrina D'Angelo and Zinsberger, the goalkeeper's being mixed up.
Still a lot of time though, and they have the quality to get back into this. Do they have the belief? McCabe delivers. Clearance by Patton, straight to Valti. Here's Caitlin Ford. Away by Parker. Ford too strong for Blinkiller Brown. Here's Kim Little. Ford with the cross. Just bounced off the legs of Frieda Marnham. And out of play for a goal kick.
Wasn't expecting it to come all the way through. I want to see Caitlin Ford, from an Arsenal perspective, take on Sarah Mailing, take on Blinkilda Brown, get herself into the box. Because when she's a little more central, that would mean Catley overlapping down the left-hand side. She is far more dangerous, Caitlin Ford.
Kim Little, just too quick. Forced forward a little wide. penalty. No one putting any on her, any pressure on her, and McCabe had made the run.
That's better though. See how much higher Catley is. She's allowing Caitlin Ford to go inside. This time it's Leah Valti. Ford lays it back to a right-footed in-swinger. Just no purposeful run from Arsenal. Kate McCabe was already in the box. Mornin was already in the box. Russo was already in the box.
Little tug on the shirt on Russo, but she does manage to release to McCabe. And now Little, close down quickly. It's too easy to dispossess, but ball handed straight back to Arsenal. You've got to say, Aston Villa so far have played this, as you mentioned, Rachel, out of possession perfectly, forcing Arsenal out wide and backing themselves to deal with these crosses. They seem to have put in a lot so far.
Yeah, look, we are viewing position from here. Five at the back. Maz Pacheco, Sarah Merlin sitting as a back five. Out of possession. Four in front of them, only 6-8 yards in front of that bank of five. And then Rach Daly up front, just putting a little bit of pressure on. So hard to play through.
Merlin gives it to Mornham. Now Russo driving forward. Patton gets back. Concede another corner.
That's better, getting the ball and driving towards the box, committing players. We saw an edgy one between McGill and McCabe, could have been awarded as a penalty. One of those players with a pace like Russo and McCabe to do more of that, Caitlin Ford.
Corner. Oh, it's an awkward one for Van Domselaar. And it's nodded just wide.
That's where the sunshine is difficult for the goalkeeper. She'd like a pair of those sunglasses you can see everyone in the crowd wearing. But not allowed. The ball's drifting high in the air and you're looking directly into the sun. It's Kate McCabe for Arsenal at the back post who just doesn't keep her eyes on it. Valti, sorry, my fault. Leah Valti. Just can't redirect it goalwards. And Domselaar comes and misses, and another mistake could have been capitalised on by Arsenal.
Break in play. Clash of heads. So, let's hope these two are okay after this clash. And a chance for both sides to collect themselves, because it's another potentially surprise result here at the Emirates. Lots of time to go, but the unlikeliest of goal scorers has given Villa the lead.
Yeah, I think she'll just be getting over the shock of this one. 2016 is a long time ago, but look how much space she has. Ilestet just completely misjudges the header, gets nowhere near it. There's a centre-half, that's got to be your strength. Maz Pacheco, one of the smallest players on the pitch, just goes in completely unmarked and nods it home, simple as that.
An understated celebration from Carla Ward.
As I said in commentary, she will have expected and told her team, been honest with her team, that they are going to concede possession, and that's why they're playing in that 5-4-1 formation. McGill on the left side of the four is an attacking player, will help to put pressure on, but also an experienced player who can fulfil a role that is designated to it. And that 5-4-1 has been so hard for Arsenal to break down.
Looks like it's going to be a sore one for Frieda Mornham. Bang on the nose.
Yeah, it was Lucy Staniforth who went up for a header, Lucy Staniforth went to flick it on, so flicked her head backwards, and it's the back of Staniforth's head that has splattered the nose of Rita Mornham. Can't see exactly it, but yeah, definitely a nose. Sounds obvious when she turns around and there's two cotton ball buds stuck up it.
Not ideal to have to continue with those up the nose.
It's so hard to breathe when you're running around and you've got those stuck up your nose. But at least it's not a concussion for either player. That's been determined, it seems, by the medical staff, and that it looks like both players were getting cleaned up to carry on.
Different climates in the Emirates Stadium. And our next offering for you, Leicester City against Manchester City. Next Saturday, BBC Two, we start at 5 o'clock. Earlier on, Leicester got a fantastic result against Manchester United, 1-1 it finished. And you can see all the highlights from all the games in the Women's Football Show tonight, 20 past midnight, or on the iPlayer. That'll be an interesting one to watch. Leicester started the season incredibly well, as they finished it under Willie Kirk. Sent forward by Illestet, and out of play.
Yeah, Willie Kirk brought them back from the dead, really. I think they were rock bottom when he took over. And possibly even pointless at that point. So, great signings as well, but fabulous to see Mornham back on the pitch.
Have to keep an eye on her. So it's not ideal conditions for high performance. We have royalty among us. Serena Wiegmann. Another England squad announcement to come.
Not warm enough for the black bomber jacket. And coat on.
Russo. Good strong running. Pies it in towards Mornham. But it hesitant at the back for Villa, but it is collected by Van Domselaar.
A good run from Russo down that right-hand side. Starts in that nine roll, doesn't she? But then looks at where the channel of space is. And an interesting one, because will Serena Wiegmann want Russo in one of those front three spots? Will Rachel Daly manoeuvre her way into a central number nine roll for England under Serena Wiegmann? Trust whoever she chooses.
Lucy Parker called up, but didn't make any appearances the last time. She's had a good, strong start to her career at Villa.
Yeah, the conveyor belt talent from St George's Park and the 15, 17s, all the age groups that England getting stronger and stronger. The more players playing at grassroots feed into that setup is enviable across the world.
Really good touch from Mornham. Little. Crosses dug out. Towards Caitlin Ford. Again, Villa do enough. Hatley on the byline. Managed to keep possession and find through the Mornham. Towards goal. And Van Domselaar had it covered.
Good feet. As soon as that got cut back onto the right foot, Van Domselaar recognised that cue and moved herself over to the near post. Leah Valti there, positioned the spot on Van Domselaar. Probably another one who's wanting to catch the eye of Serena Wiegmann. Former Dutch manager, of course.
Not sure she's even at her disposal at that time. Was brought in after the first game of the Euros after an injury to Van Veenendaal and has kept the shirt. Rightly so. So 5 minutes to go until the break. Now Jonas Eidevall and these supporters inside the Emirates Stadium of an Arsenal persuasion would like a goal before the break. Ford then driving towards two players. Referee says the ball was won cleanly. Arsenal win it back. Frieda Mornar. Russo had made the run. Good tracking there from Rachel Corsi. Just to block off her path.
Yeah, that experience of that back line with Rachel Corsi and Danielle Turner. Hannah Patton. Coming up, this is their second full season at Aston Villa. Those three have been formidable so far and have really protected Van Domselaar. Clever signing. All of her experience in the US for Rachel Corsi. Clever signing from Carla Ward.
Space for Russo. Numbers making their way into the box, but also Villa do enough to stop her progress. And good take from Van Domselaar, who perhaps wasn't expecting it.
Yeah, you've got to get a position in where you can deal with moving to the left for a cross or moving to the near post for a shot. It was kind of in between, wasn't it, really? Positioning where it should never have really tested Van Domselaar. I don't think it did.
Taken by Daly. Oh, and that's a swipe from Rachel Daly. A frustration coming through. Arsenal have taken it quickly. And they're not going to be allowed to. It's being brought back. A yellow card has been given, perhaps to Rachel Daly. Not surprising for that challenge. I think she was indicating that she couldn't see. Let's have a look.
Seemed a little petulant, if nothing else. I don't think she made any contact with McCabe, but she does. No, she doesn't. So McCabe anticipates contact and doesn't make a big deal of it and say anything to the referee. Just doesn't put the brakes on Rach Daly.
Catley delivers towards Valti and Russo and off the line. And the block from Turner. Heroic stuff at the back for Aston Villa.
There's a player down. Rachel Daly. Part of that joint effort to keep the ball out of the Villa net. Reasonable ball in. Valti tries to steer it goalwards, then Russo, and a combined effort of Rachel Daly in the middle. Gets up, Anna Patton just cleans into the back of her. Arsenal corner, they'd be desperate to level things up.
Another chance not taken for Arsenal. They've come very close, haven't managed to force their way through.
Look how many players are in that six-yard box. That is so difficult. Everyone shielding their eyes from the sunshine. It's chaos in there. The ball whipped in with pace.
And Domselaar does just enough through a crowd of players. McCabe. Turner gets ahead to the ball first. Frieda Mornar. Illestet has stayed up there. Kim Little. Mayland gets her foot to it. been taken too quickly for the referee's liking. 4 minutes of time added on.
Well, it's because there's a player down, Rachel Corsi, he sat down in the box and the ref blew the whistle just as Arsenal were taking a throw-in. Maybe that's a little attempt.
So the yellow card was given to Laz Pacheco. I think it was for this, as they tried to take the free kick. She wasn't the requisite distance away. And it is those sorts of incidents that are being taken much more seriously this season.
As a footballer, you think something or nothing, but it seems to be those petty acts that are being PGMOL, the referees are wanting to stamp out.
So 3 minutes of stoppage time remaining. Even more. More than. The player staying touch tight.
It's far too long into this first half that Arsenal recognised that Catley and Maritz could go higher up, with only Rachel Daly occupying the two centre halves. That's where they have had their joy. Catley and Maritz have gone higher up to support McCabe and Caitlin Ford.
Maritz dispossessed, and Rachel Daly, well, I think she was trying to go for goal there.
Yeah, she saw Zinsberger outside her 18-yard box. Thought, I fancy running all that way in. Hit it from here. Good tackle back from Valti, who gave an earful to Illestet, who'd given the ball away.
Here's Maritz. On to Simone McGill. Got a bit of space to run into here. Answers nicely for Frieda Mornham. Ford wins it back. Mornham away from Sarah Mayling. Forced wide. Too wide. We know she can hit them from outside the area, but again, it's really sound defensive play.
Yes, no one at any point made that shot on goal easy. See Dan Turner getting across to really narrow the window that was available to her to shoot. After some excellent defensive work from Sarah Mayling, just jostling with her. Run infield from Caitlin Forge. Will he be planning to say at half-time? What changes will he look to make? So Arsenal have good options off the bench, but Blackstenius potentially instead of Mornham.
Who will be the one to unlock a stubborn Villa defence?
We need someone to run at them. Mornham's reasonable at that. Blackstenius. Russo's got the awareness to drop a little deeper if required. Blackstenius running behind. Good option for me.
Ford. Ops to check back. Balti. Lacked conviction with that cross. Easily cleared. Too long for Villa to hold on.
It's been almost flawless from a Carla Ward tactical point of view from how they've executed the game plan. Aston Villa.
Here's McCabe. Kim Little. Challenge from Turner was fair according to the referee.
Time from Danielle Turner.
half time. Half a job well done for Aston Villa, who have soaked up the pressure and scored a goal by Maz Pacheco, 7 years in the making, on track, heading home, and giving Arsenal yet another headache. Still 45 minutes for the Gunners to remedy this, but it's a familiar feeling this season. Just 1 point from their opening two games. Is it going to be another negative result for them? We'll have to see. But at half time, it's Arsenal 0, Aston Villa 1.
Thank you, Robin. Thank you, Rachel. I've got Anita Asante and Jilly Flatty alongside me for this one. Anita, frustrated Emirates crowd here from that performance, even though Arsenal dominated possession, a real disciplined performance from Aston Villa.
Yeah, absolutely. I think Arsenal largely played in Villa's half, the first half, but they're not able to really create real clear-cut chances in the box, and they're not ruthless enough. But that's credit to the system and the shape that Villa are playing in. They've got five defenders in the box, making it very difficult for them to exploit that space.
Yeah, Carla Ward wanted a bigger performance than that game last week against Liverpool, and she's got it from her team.
Yes, I mean, it's a hugely improved performance. I think last week against Liverpool, they showed them too much respect, Villa. You know, Malian had a bit of a bad game last weekend. You know, defensively, crosses were coming in too easy. It's not happening today. You know, they're doubling up in positions. They're just a lot more defensively astute today, and it's showing in that first half performance.
OK, well, let's take a look at the first goal. Maz Pacheco. Anita, it's her first goal in the WSL.
I mean, incredible, you know, that she's been able to get on the score sheet. She's, you know, stature-wise, one of the smallest players in the team as well. And you can see here, nobody is tracking her run. There's no contact or blocks to make that a difficult header. And it's quite an easy, you know, goal for her to score. And Arsenal have got to be really frustrated with that, because that is just poor defending from a set piece.
Yeah, and obviously we spoke as well when we was watching it back that sometimes if you're a player down in that situation, you might leave the player that's the least threat. But with Illicit in the zone of where we are, she has to attack that ball. You know, she times it completely wrong. A lot of the players are just watching their player rather than looking at where the ball is and where the danger is. Steph Catley follows her player that runs the opposite direction rather than stepping to Pacheco. And, I mean, it's a great finish by Pacheco as well.
That's what do you do in that situation then, Anita? Is it who's taking control? Where's the communication coming from?
Well, you want someone in that zone to lead and just command and start pulling players into spaces. And I think in that scenario, they're just too preoccupied with my player. I've got to mark that player, as opposed to what's the danger? I need to be able to see the flight of the ball and the player make contact.
Yeah, I think, Spo, speaking just before that as well, Arsenal were dominating possession, 77% possession before that goal actually went in. But they are creating chances. And you said, Jilly, watching the actual game, that it was coming down from the wide channels.
Yeah, I mean, they did have a lot of success in the wide areas. But we spoke as well during the game that it's just those choices that they make when they are in those final third areas. Like Ford here, she's a great dribbler of the ball. She puts it in. But you can see Arsenal numbers, they're already in the box. You haven't got no late runner. And it's really difficult when Villa are defending in a five and they're standing there waiting to then attack that ball. Again, going down into the wide areas here. Arsenal have used the width really well, really well. Obviously, then you see Maritz getting in there, but it's now you've only got two bodies running in there against a back five.
The thing that worries me about the Arsenal side is when they get into those wide areas, they're getting into crossing situations, but the players in the box aren't doing everything they can to get on the ball. You know, make those darting runs and commit 100% to try and get anything. Throw your body at it.
Yeah.
They're just waiting for something to happen and reacting.
I suppose that's where the crowd now wanting to see, especially in the second half, someone like Beth Mead to come onto the pitch. But let's have a look, because like we said, they're creating chances. Let's have a look at the best ones, especially from Leah Walty, Anita.
Yeah, I think, you know, we know what Leah can do, her vision, her ability to find a pass and a delivery again in a scenario. It's a brilliant cross into the box and it evades everybody in the Aston Villa defence. And it's just, again, someone throwing it themselves at the ball, trying to make... you know, commit themselves and really do everything they can. Even if they come out with a bloody nose, those are the scenarios you've got to go for.
Yeah, and I think as well, obviously, Van Domselaar as well on that one previously. Obviously, she comes flying out nowhere near it. Obviously, Russo's chance there. They are creating, and that's the main thing that they can take into the second half, is they are creating. I just need that finishing touch.
Still yet to get a win in the WSL this season, Anita.
I mean, I wouldn't have put money on it at all. You know, for the quality of this squad, the depth they have, you'd expect them to be able to, you know, dominate these games, but be ruthless and score and get themselves in a position where they're picking up results.
What do you think is down to this slow start for them?
I think it's hard. I think you've got new players coming in. Obviously, you've got Russo coming in as well. And there's a lot of hype about Russo, that pressure as well. And it's about building those partnerships up. But I think there is a lot of talk of Arsenal haven't done this yet. They haven't got their win. And it's that pressure. So I think if a game like today, they just manage to nick the win, it will relieve so much from them.
And I think perhaps the rotation isn't necessarily helping them. We've all played for this club when we, you know, when we had success. I think we predominantly played with a core, you know, a goalkeeper that's predominantly played, a backline that's been relatively consistent. And sometimes you need that continuity when it's just not clicking for you.
Yeah, we can see Beth Mead there going through her warm-ups. Aren't we going to see her? But before that, let's take a look at what you've got coming up on BBC today. So from 4 o'clock on Sound, you can listen to live commentary from the Rugby World Cup as England play Fiji. And on BBC Two at 5:20, you can watch the Super League Grand Final highlights, and you can catch up with all the highlights from the WSL this weekend on the Women's Football Show tonight on BBC One just after midnight. And on the iPlayer, there's this.
This is the Hawks United Academy.
Imagine playing there every single day.
Only the best will progress.
Bring it on.
Welcome to the jungle.
Jamie Johnson's scholarship program going to cause friction within the team.
Let's sell this on the pitch. You're on.
Decent training.
Why are we even here?
Because you're good. Because Jamie saw something brilliant in you. Show me you deserve to be here. Show me how hungry you are.
Jamie Johnson FC. Watch now on BBC iPlayer.
Okay, I'm going to leave you two for a moment. I'm going to be back as we walk over this way because we are delighted. She can see me walking towards her right now. She's giving me a big smile to be joined by Arsenal and England captain Leah Williamson. Thank you for joining us on this one. Leah, I suppose when you look around the stadium, I think over the last two games, 90,000 fans would have come and watched Arsenal women. How big is that for the club and actually for the sport?
Yeah, it's massive, and those games are back-to-back. You know, it's not like there's been months in between and everyone's missing it. They're coming back again and again and again now. It shows the sustainability is growing and we're on our way.
Yeah, and then actually give us an update on your injury. How's that going?
Yeah, it's good. It's good. I'm running. I'm kicking a football like I used to. I don't feel any different, so that's good. The lungs need a little bit of time to catch up.
Back out on the training pitch. The runs, yeah. The box.
You know the runs. You know the runs. I'm weaving and 15 on, 15 off.
But besides your rehab, talk to us a bit about what you've been doing off the pitch as well, because you took a trip over to a refugee camp in Jordan. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so it's important to me. So an initiative set up by the club where basically we go and try and change lives and try and give them some independence, something to focus on through the power of football, but also a place to call home. They don't have a home. They're in a refugee camp, and Arsenal's always spoken about that family feel. So I went out there, spent some time with the girls, did some football sessions. Not much football for me. They were better than me, but yeah.
Sparking just, the orders.
Yeah, yeah. Stand on the side. I was in a coaching. But it's just important. I don't want to look back on these 9 months and think I haven't done things that I've wanted to do for a long time.
Well, Leah, you've been doing huge things because you also spoke at the UN.
Yeah. Yes, I did. Again, I don't really know how I end up in these situations, but it's an opportunity to speak on gender equality, things that I believe in, things that we would sit and go on about until, you know, whenever. So, yeah, just trying to use my platform, trying to give people that don't have a voice, and I'm blessed. So I need to, do as much as I can for other people.
Okay, Leah, and another huge moment. You finally got your OBE.
Yeah, I did.
Big moment for you and your family.
Yeah, I'm glad. I really appreciated it by the time it came round. So a nice day out, a nice moment to reflect on where I've come from, but you know me, still so much more to do. So, yeah.
Is this where I can tell everyone at home actually that you can actually, what went on with the outfit?
The outfit, yeah, my trousers split, yeah, so I received my OBE, not in my best form, but no one knew about it until you just told the whole world, so thanks.
I had to tell everyone. Yeah. But actually, let's talk about your team, Arsenal's slow start to the season. What do you put that down to?
Yeah, I don't know, so, you know, we've been lucky, we've had good starts the last couple of years, not much time, the schedule is it's ridiculous. The girls have had, I think, before the first game or even after the Champions League, it was something like 8 sessions in the last 4 months.
Yeah.
And you expect a team to be able to gel quickly. But also, I just think we're just not at our level. And the girls know that we're chasing a better level, but we should be doing better. And the girls are playing good today, but, you know, results-wise, sometimes just not with you.
Need a big performance in the second half. Okay, thank you for joining me, but stay here one moment because there was a game last night in the WSL, and that was between current champions Chelsea taking on West Ham. If you missed the highlights, well, actually, we're going to show you some highlights. If you missed the game, here's some highlights for you.
Right. Oh, that's a bit sloppy by Shimizu. Could be problems here. Kirby sent it on. Charles, first time ball in. Oh, she missed an earlier chance. Very rare that she misses more than one. And she continues this exceptional record against West Ham. 11 goals now in 7 games against them for Sam Kerr. And she's scored in 6 of those 7 matches she's played against them. Sissoko. Oh, she's given it away now. Ingles onto it. It's Kirby. Kerr one way, goes to James. Should be 2. And Mackenzie Arnold makes a massive save. Oh, that could be a big moment in the game. On the stroke of half time, did ever so well to keep James at bay. And that's a good try by Smith. Helped over the top by Zecira Musovic. Keep ball will do for Chelsea now. Perhaps they want more than that. Cuthbert, Fleming, Cuthbert, this to seal it. And she has done. Chelsea sign off in style. That wraps up the points. And that puts the seal on the win for Chelsea.
Yeah, Chelsea back to winning ways. Anita, what will Jonas Eidevall be saying to his players in there?
Well, I think he'll be saying that they really need to up the tempo in the final third, start to isolate players a bit more, try and get in those 1v1, 2v1 situations to drag out the Aston Villa defence, because at the moment they're really disciplined and in defending every cross that's coming into the box.
Yeah, I completely agree. I think it's about now in the final third, when you do get in there, I want to see more buddies busting the gut in to get into the box. If you are already in there, can you make a second movement to try and, like Nate said, move that Aston Villa defence?
But then how do Aston Villa maintain this lead, Julie?
They carry on doing what they've done that first half, defending really well. Just make sure they don't get deeper and deeper, because obviously as the second half goes on, Arsenal are going to be pushing for that goal. You can tend to drop and deep and deep, and you're just encouraging Arsenal one more, but taking care of it now when you go forward too.
OK, but will it actually, Nita, is it hard for Aston Villa, because they have not created many chances? Defensively, they need to stay switched on.
Absolutely. Now it's about concentration, because you know any mistake can lead to an opportunity. And I think for Villa, it's the first and second phase. Can you retain the ball a bit longer to get relief to your team and get numbers up the pitch and gain territory?
OK, let's remind you of all the action from the first half.
The pressure mounting. You can smell the jeopardy in the air. It's an awkward one for Van Gonselaar. Couldn't hold it. Arsenal in control, but nothing to show for it so far. Saliforth delivers. Son Pacheco! Villa in front! It's a towering header! Arsenal behind again. And now Arsenal's opponents have something to hold on to.
Okay, Anita, do you think Arsenal can actually get something from this game?
Absolutely they can. They've got so much talent in this squad on the pitch at the minute, and it's the belief now and the real desire to be ruthless in the final third.
Okay, yeah, they really need some leadership coming from that group. Let's get you back up to our commentary team. Rachel Brown-Finnis is alongside Robin Cowan.
Yes, thank you very much, Alex. No changes for either side. So Jonas Eidevall would like the current 11 to try and get back into this game themselves, but I'm sure there's a few alternatives up his sleeve if required. So far it's been a tactical plan executed to perfection by Aston Villa. Something is going to have to change in terms of Arsenal's approach play, or just the final product, Rachel.
Yeah, we saw, as we mentioned a couple of times, that the fullbacks for Arsenal, because they only had the one centre-half of Rach Daly to engage them, allow both fullbacks to bomb on, but I'm sure the fans will be desperate to see Beth Mead bring a bit of that sparkle and magic. You know, golden boot in the European Championships. Seems so long ago for these Arsenal fans, and they've lost her for the best part of a whole year.
Here we go then, Arsenal get us underway. As Pacheco's goal, the difference so far from a corner that was poorly defended by Arsenal. I think we'll expect Arsenal to continue to have most of the possession. Let's see. They changed their approach in trying to break Villa down.
Interesting to see whether Villa do push on and try and take a bit more of their play to Arsenal. Sure, they'll not want to defend for the next 45 minutes. They'll also be happy with the efficient job that they have done.
That's what it boils down to. One corner, one goal. That's all it took for Liverpool on the opening day against Arsenal.
Poor statistical reading for Arsenal, though.
There is intercept. Some signing from PSG. Had a tremendous World Cup with Sweden. Four goals, just one behind the Golden Boot winner. Here's Caitlin Ford.
Team in the world now, Sweden.
Another bronze medal for them. Little. Not quite enough precision on the ball. It has to be perfect with the defence lining the edge of the penalty area. One back by Staniforth. Patton. Tackles flying in, nailing. Went to ground but couldn't keep the ball. And here's Ruben Moy. On to McCabe. Van Domselaar straight to Kim Little. Decision has given Arsenal's way.
Arsenal certainly did not make the most of their set pieces in the first half, whether it be corners or balls from similar positions. I'm sure it's something that Ada Ball will have addressed at half-time.
Mornham, Pacheco, heads it away, Balti back in. Molly from Russo, and play's going to have to be stopped here. She hit that so cleanly, and Rachel Corsi took the full force of it.
Brilliant block. It's a lovely volley from Russo. We've not watched it back yet, but it seemed to be hit completely true, right out the centre of her foot. Watching it all the way, look at that technique. It does hit her in the head, and absolutely stoppage, because that was top speeds. Rachel Corsi has been excellent at the centre of that three for Carla Ward in defence.
Most blocks per 90 this season. There's another one for Rachel Corsi, and one that's one of the most painful ones, but one for the team.
Look at position, see, she just checks away from Ford there, down the line of the ball, which makes the goal a fraction smaller. And just like goalkeeping and making saves, defensive play is about getting in the right position. Excellent from Rachel Corsi.
Perhaps a few secrets being shared. Leanne Hall, who joined in August from Arsenal to join the backroom staff at Aston Villa. Maybe a bit of prior knowledge.
Yeah, former teammate of me, former England goalkeeper, Leanne Hall. And she was the goalkeeper coach initially at Arsenal for a good few seasons. She's an A-licensed coach. And if I've undersold that, I apologise, Leanne, if you are a pro-licence. But an outfield specialist as well as goalkeeper coach, and takes up the role of assistant alongside Carla Ward. With very few former international players in those coaching roles, and we'll see more and more of those.
Turning away from Simone McGill. Big day for her. Ruptured her at ACL while playing for Northern Ireland at the Euros. So it's been a long, long road back for her. A few sub appearances in the WSL at the back end of last season. First start though. Here's Lucy Parker, summer edition from West Ham. Rewarding run forward, but it's one back. Turner gets there ahead of Alessia Russo, who will close down the goalkeeper, and that's coolly done.
Needs an option.
A few hearts in mouth, but it seems that Villa had this under control. Again, composure personified by Anna Patton. Work their way out of a sticky situation, Aston Villa.
It's just up their possession stats, that play across the back. It's a lot more intent. You see Lucy Parker's wanting to drive forwards in that central midfield role and not just satisfied with using Rachel Daly as an out and carry possession off Arsenal. They want to bring their game in possession to Arsenal this second half.
Daly finds Pacheco, invites McGill forward, cuts inside Illestet. It's Daly making the run, busting a gut to get there.
Great run from Simone McGill, does exceptionally well to cut it onto a favoured right foot. Oh, it's just a fraction of timing that means that Rachel Daly can't get a clean header on that. Good intent from Villa.
Little closed down by Parker. Mornham gets a foot in and finds Alessia Russo. Trying to get away from Turner. Advantage played. Here's Valti. Turns away from Stanifor. Deflection takes it to Patton, who just about makes the clearance. Ooh, Ruben Moy. Daly on the stretch. Gets the foul.
Clever. Rach Daly there, just letting Kim Little run to the back of her. And gaining a bit of time and respite for her team. It was Leah Valti who had that shot on goal, just kept looking, having a touch and looking. There was no forward movement, no one trying to get into the gaps between the centre-halves for Arsenal. And that's where they've really struggled to open Villa up.
There's Blinkiller Brown. Play. It's the Sarah-Mailing, who has stayed down. Just slowly getting back to her feet.
Instructions on the sideline were given to Pilova, running through set pieces on the iPad. That looks like that is the next change to be made for Arsenal. Tireless work rate from Rachel Daly, not allowing Illestep possession or comfortable possession of the ball.
Will we see Beth Mead? It's going to give the crowd a huge lift. Of course, you do have to be careful with these things. Although Jonas Edervall did say in the pre-match press conference that she wouldn't be on the bench if she wasn't ready. She didn't come through all the training sessions, all the checks. Catley. Now Ford. Digs the cross out. Patton there. Villa seem to be winning all those headers in the box when Arsenal get that far. Morning. Over Russo. But it does reach her now. Great block from McGill. Nearly a Russo special. She's so sharp on the turn, but she was prevented a clear path to goal.
Yeah, good experience defending from McGill. Great to see her back, by the way. First major tournament, Northern Ireland. Cruciate out for, you know, over a year. Former teammate of mine, Northern Irish superstar, and this time using her experience to thwart Alessia Russo. It's been more hopeful than synchronised for Arsenal in that final third. You know, the chance of it dropping at the feet of Russo and doing something special on her own rather than team synchronised build-ups. And just see now Kim Little, there was a tackle that went on just a few minutes ago. I think it was between her and Sarah Mailing. And to see her being treated with their ever-presence in the second spell back at Arsenal. Yeah, just one that Kim Little had under control and slid into play the pass more than for it to be a tackle. Sarah Mailing less so in control. Right under the nose of Amy Fearn. Sarah Mailing maybe glad of no VAR. Let's hope that Kim Little can ride out this one and it's nothing too serious.
Not a sight Arsenal fans want to see. She has been busy in midfield, trying to thread those passes through.
Nearing that magical 60-minute mark where it seems a green light for substitutions to be made.
Top. Nicely done, Rachel Corsi.
Excellent composure, Rachel Corsi. And of course, Serena Wiegmann will be keeping her eye on the likes of Rachel Corsi and Kim Little. Team GB manager confirmed for Paris Olympics this upcoming summer.
Okay, comes away with it. Staniforth just getting to her feet now. Here's Steph Catley. Dinkler Brow on the charge. Finds Daly. On to Maz Pacheco. Fuller's forward line flooding forwards, but Daly can't collect. Back in Arsenal possession. Getting ready for a couple of changes. Some freshening up required. Victoria Pullover. Chloe Lacasse, who scored the memorable equaliser at Lee Sports Village last Friday night.
It's gone really flat, hasn't it, across that forward line. Mornham barely had a touch this second half. Russo seems to be doing most of the running herself. Not a lot of support. Pullover and Lacasse will certainly inject a bit of unpredictability into that Arsenal front line.
Corner kick in front of the clock end. And Aston Villa scored their goal. Teasing delivery, good distance on the punch from Van Domselaar. Little works it back out to Mornham. Good take from Van Domselaar.
Looking assured in both of those interceptions there, Van Domselaar. One punch, one catch. So Kate McKay remonstrating on this near side, playing on the right, just signalling to a team to speed up the tempo of the game, the passing round the back, the switching of the ball.
So Frieda Mornham off. Chloe Lacasse. Summer signing from Benfica. Canadian international. And Amanda Illestet off for Victoria Pullover. It'll be interesting to see if this marks a change of shape, perhaps.
I think Katie McCabe will just go on that left-hand side. Catley will come into it. Either a back three. Or as one of the centre-halves.
Russo. Kept hold of it well, but forced back.
Yeah, Catley and Vubbenmoy, centre-halves, Katie McCabe left-back, Norma Ritz right-back, and Pullover, as you would expect. Out onto this, sorry, Lacasse on the right-hand side. Pullover in that role that Mornham has just come off. Certainly a more fizzy type of player, more energetic player. More tinkering from Jonas Eidevall. Trying to get that back line right, isn't he?
Selected by Daly. Flag is up.
Yeah, you can't.
A offside and a free kick for Arsenal, who need to find something here. And you mentioned it, Rachel, it's gone flat.
Yeah, Villa don't have to do a single thing. They can just sit off and bank up and defend and congest the central areas as they have done. Keep making life difficult for Arsenal. They've done their bit.
Moritz, no one closing her down. Time to measure the cross. Caitlin Ford rose but couldn't direct it on target. Here's Kim Little. Into Ford. Rolls it off the post. Oh, and Russo couldn't turn it in. That looked like a touch from Van Domselaar.
What a save this is. It's a wonderful ball through from Kim Little. I think she's gone higher in the morning position, and Palova and Volti are sitting in front of the back four, and it's Kim Little who threads the ball through. Caitlin Ford rolls a defender, and Domselaar thinks it's in. She sat down, but it rebounds into her domain. She's able to react and scoop the ball away just in time as it goes back there. Scoop it away from Russo. Russo should have buried that with her first touch. See, she's alive on this pitch. Caitlin Ford, whether that's across to Lacasse, it misses. Oh, and Russo just can't adjust her feet enough to be able to open that hip up and side foot it home. That touch gives Dom Van Domselaar the chance to react better, and he applauds that better.
A couple of opportunities that have just not quite gone their way, the bounce of the ball, but I want to say that was brave and decisive from Van Domselaar, and that is why she was so sought after in the summer.
Well, Eidevall recognised that there was not someone threading balls through to Caitlin Ford or to Russo, and putting Kim Little, the little magician, as they call her, in that higher position. That's exactly what she can do.
Really good turn as well. Caitlin Ford off the post. Arsenal's luck is out again. McCabe on to Ford. Passing another run at Mailing. Lova works it out to Ruben Moy. Oh, that's a not bad ball, but front foot off her line quickly. Van Domselaar.
Yeah, excellent command in that second 6 yard box. She recognised the cue. She saw Russo come across. Her defender was going to be free at that near post, and Domselaar just snuffed out and commanded that area.
Over 35,000 here at the Emirates. Another very good crowd. The main stadium. The women's team. The pass, that looked like a handball, and that's unfortunate.
It is, because it was a brilliant ball from Katie McCabe, who just took the ball down and saw Lacasse stretch the back line down that channel. Had the beating of Dan Turner, who's been excellent, by the way, today. Not difficult to see that one touch the hand.
Still 22 minutes plus stoppages to go. Arsenal having one of their better periods.
Still Van Domselaar, other than that one scramble away, it's not hard. Vincent save to have to make yet.
The pass. Van Domselaar a little bit more busy now.
It's all balls into the box. Dealing with corners, which has been excellent and is a hugely influential part of a goalkeeper's game. It's not that final output that Arsenal would want, which is really testing the goalkeeper with shots on goal. Something that they've really struggled to create this afternoon.
pass on to Russo. Flag is up. Little bit of carelessness. Just creeping into Villa.
Don't understand why Lacasse plays that. Surely even she can see that she's offside.
When you had an encounter with Sean Macielis, didn't you, before the before kickoff?
Yeah, and just like Serena, juggling mum life and professional life isn't always easy. Sean Macielis' little daughter wants to bring every single one of her toys into the stadium. She was trying to deter her from doing so. We've all been there and done that, haven't we?
As if you're sat next to a little girl with 100 dolls. You know who her mum is, running the line.
She did tell me she was very excited to see Beth Mead today. She's an Arsenal fan. Not Sean Macielis, but a daughter.
Well, we see her. Still 20 minutes to go. Imagine if she does come on, it won't be for a while yet. Foul committed by Caitlin Ford. And no further punishment this time.
Very similar to Rachel Daly's tackle that got her booked against Katie McCabe. Here, big moment for Jordan Nobbs, long-term former Arsenal player.
Daly scurrying away. Finds Simone McGill, back to goal. Lays it off. McGill receives it back. Good block from Ruben Moy. Really good work.
Excellent work from Simone McGill. She was about 19 when she joined Everton, and she already had about 50 caps in Northern Ireland at that point. And she has put a shift in this afternoon, and if that is the last kick of the game for her, then she has done herself and her team very, very proud. It is her who makes way for Jordan Nobbs.
And reception from all supporters inside the Emirates for Jordan Nobbs, 12 years at Arsenal. Sandiford's corner. Moy got the flick on, retrieved by Steph Catley.
Running out of ideas, running out of time, possibly Arsenal. Is there a magic moment for Beth Mead to come?
Pass pursued by Evelyn Killer Brown. No foul on Corsi. Goes down. Kim Little just shouldered off it by Lucy Parker.
Down the middle of the pitch, Aston Villa have been excellent, haven't they? Mitchell Corsi, Dan Turner, Lucy Parker, just to name a few.
Pass wins the throw, takes it quickly. Here's Kim Little. Close down quickly. It's those moments where Aston Villa have been so, so effective. The well-timed challenges. decision making.
Just had composure in tight areas, areas that have really mattered. Dan Turner's shown excellent pace to match Leslie Russo on a number of occasions.
Straight to McCabe, who claims for handball there. Russo, of course, he read the turn. Makes the clearance.
Castle are squeezing Aston Villa now. Testing Rachel Corsi and her team to the limits.
Arsenal substitution, Leo Valti.
Arsenal going for it now. Leo Valti off. Stina Blackstenius on. Midfielder for a forward. Needs must. Aston Villa will have to prepare for the expected peppering of their goal. So far there's been no panic.
Dina Blackstenius will offer a double target up top with Leslie Russo. A real physical presence, go one to one with Rachel Corsi and Danielle Turner. Anna Patton. Different threat.
Hello there. Lacasse. Away from Parker. The pass, hugging the touchline.
And that's what Villa have done excellently well, isn't it? Every time that they've got past Maspacek on the left-hand side, Sarah Mayley on the right-hand side, one of those three centre-halves has just been in the right position to sweep up any danger.
Pullover. Now Little. McCabe. Towards Russo, he claims the handball, and the ricochet from McCabe's shot favours Villa. Corner kick.
Bodies on the line, last-ditch defending. Jonas Eidevall wants the stadium to get on their feet and get Arsenal over the line. He is stretching the back line. Lovely play, lovely dinking from McCabe. Good defending once again from Villa. I think it's Anna Patton who gets across and makes that goal-saving block.
Catley cleared at the near post. Cuts inside of Blinkiller Brown. Swing from Blackstenius didn't connect. McCabe this time, Catley wide.
Being a bit of an onslaught now. Villa having to camp out. And Domslaw has just sat down in her own box. The crowd have made their own assumptions as to what that means. You see how congested it is. Finally, it's Catley who heads wide. And should have done better, really. Prior to that, Blackstenius, I thought, had an excellent chance at the far post. Just snatched at it and didn't get anything on it. And it allowed then the ball to drop. And for Villa once again to clear easily.
Well, Arsenal clearly need to get back into the game. And so the passing of play reflects that. But Pullover, Chloe Lacasse, have made good impact off the bench. Positive.
Yeah, Lacasse in particular down this right-hand side. More pace down the right, stretching the back five out of Aston Villa, making Maspacek step out towards Lacasse. has just opened up those gaps in between, and now Villa have got to consider Blackstenius in that more advanced position. Those gaps are where Arsenal could get themselves back in this game with only 10 minutes to go. We say 10 minutes, but it ain't going to be 10 minutes, is it, Robin? What's your guess?
Not sure we're allowed to open the betting on the BBC, but yeah, stoppage time has become that sort of affair. Blackstenius, who dropped with the shoulder, forced away from goal. Maritz, now Lucas. Halova threads it for Russo. Maritz! Again, Villa defend so well. Oh, and Ruben Moy landed on Rachel Daly there. Both players committed to getting the ball, just an unfortunate outcome.
I think she'll be fine. From Rach Daly. She's put a real shift in for her team, knowing that as a number nine it was not going to be all about everything she did in Arsenal's box. It's going to be what she's doing out of possession. She's done that job relentlessly in an exemplary manner, and Bubba Moy just landing the midriff of Rach Daly, I think it's probably winded her. I'm sure she'll get back up and carry on. Is Bumway set to lead that centre-half pairing for the rest of the season? Arsenal through and through. Wonderful role model for youngsters, for both Arsenal, the Gooners, and as a lioness.
And next up from us, from the BBC, WSL, Leicester City against Manchester City. BBC Two next Saturday from 5, and the women's football show tonight, or tomorrow at least, 20 past midnight, or 10 o'clock on the iPlayer, with guests Farrah Williams and Gilly Flaherty doing double time today with Kelly Summers.
Just heard shouts of Mido. And this is why what fans, Lioness fans, Arsenal fans have been desperate to see for such a long time, as probably only a tiny percentage as much as she has been waiting to see. And I don't mean you, Serena, sorry, I meant Beth Mead. But great for Serena Wiegmann to be able to witness Beth Mead. But certainly Arsenal have missed that sparkle down the right-hand side.
So from an England perspective, great to see Fran Kirby back playing for Chelsea yesterday. Slowly but surely, those key players returning. Lucas, been heavily involved since her introduction. Okay, delivers towards Lucas. Back in by Maritz. High looping ball and difficult one for Stina Blackstenius.
It's that final ball, isn't it, Robin, that Arsenal have really, really struggled with unlocking the defence of Aston Villa. It's lacked a little purpose at times. yes, going down the right-hand side or left-hand side, but are you looking up? Are you really dictating where that ball ends up? You know, the cutback, the precision on that, cutback's rarely been used. They've just put it into the box.
Good boy. Pacheco ports. After she had cushioned the ball down, she's remained down. One back by Ford. Pacheco still on the deck. Players stopped for now. Lucy Parker with the challenge and also the thoughts afterwards, and that's going to be a yellow card for Lucy Parker.
And she's had a great game though. She's soaked up so much pressure, and you know, there's times when you do need to concede yellow cards for your team like that. And Arsenal are storming forward and wave after wave. She's played a very mature role, Lucy Parker. I'm sure will have impressed Serena Wiegmann. I think it's cramp for Maz Pacheco, by the way. She did get caught, but the goal scorer isn't getting that giant applause. It's for this girl.
Yes, it's not for the potential match winner. It is Beth Mead. 11 long months out. England's and Arsenal's hero returns. Pacheco off. Olivia McLaughlin, 19 years old today. Be a bouncing bus home if it stays like this. And also a little cameo for Ebony Salmon. Laura Blinkiller-Brown, the player removed for Aston Villa.
And Arsenal substitution, 16, Noel Merrick's.
Fitting reception for the return of Beth Mead. The script is written.
She'll have to contain her emotions of what this last year has meant to culminate in being here. What can she do?
Hatley delivers. Has won it, but it's cleared. Forced all the way back to Zinsberger. And cross in. Turner turns it away. Here's the pass. Numbers in the middle. Nearly fell for Mead. Russo, blocked by Turner. And Villa keeping their concentration.
They'll be mentally tired, they'll be physically tired now, Villa. They have to do what they have done for 89 minutes of this game. Work as a team.
Mead with a touchdown. First, in a competitive game for 11 months, here's Lacasse. Good block by Nobbs. McCabe, play by Turner. Now Catley, wave after wave. Corner kick.
Well, they're tightening the screw on Aston Villa. Just thinking for Beth Mead. It's those solitary days on the bike in the gym, those days where your exercises, all they are, is tightening your quad and trying to bend your knee past 90 degrees. weeks and weeks of those months.
Russo tracked at the near post by Parker. Laxtinius. It is all hands to the pump for Villa. Starting to get a little bit desperate in their defending, but it's effective.
Just got to stay switched on.
A number that's going to be music to the ears of the Arsenal fans. Not so, though, for Aston Villa, who are under the cosh here. McCabe. Oh, the overhead kick from Caitlin Ford.
Again, brilliant defending from Villa. An excellent punch from Van Domselaar to snuff out the first attack. And then this one from McCabe, a lovely in-swinger. Look at that for defending. Absolutely sensational.
The clock that shows good strength. No foul. Ford.
Strike from Katie McCabe, a lovely overlap. See here, Palova winning ball back from Olivia McLaughlin, and Caitlin Ford slips it through. The overlap here slides it, and Katie McCabe made no mistake from that. Nothing that any positioning or defensive setup could do about that. Van Domselaar gets to a near post, but the sheer velocity of this rocket from Katie McCabe, slipped down the left from Palova. Lovely little way to pass, and it's that precision that Arsenal have lacked so far in this game that Katie McCabe brought in that advanced left position. And we know she only ever scores bangers.
Sometimes you just got to get your foot through it. The relief palpable.
They know they've got the best part of 10 minutes to get themselves a winger, a winner even.
The touch from Mead sets Laxtinius away! Off the post for the second time. McCabe.
You wonder with Laxtinius and Russo up top, with Katie McCabe in that advanced left position, if they'd have played more of the game like this, how many more difficulties are they offering to Aston Villa? It got kind of boring halfway through the game from Arsenal. They created nothing that was scintillating up top, and now it's wave after wave of attack.
Kim Little, now Ford. Pops on the outside. Palova, and now the Cass. Ruben Moy. Into Mead. Russo! She might have just saved Arsenal. Set up by their returning number 9.
And with having Beth Mead, with that connection of Russo that they've had with England. Beth Mead draws a player, slips it infield to Russo, who has the better option. It's poor goalkeeping from Daphne van Domselaar. It squirms underneath her. She had to get a strong hand on that, but brilliant awareness from Beth Mead. A short of game time that Beth Mead is. She does exceptionally well to recognise the situation. A solid strike from Russo. Van Domselaar left with her head in her hands.
That's a good cross, and Villa now a force to come forward. They led for so long. They invited too much pressure.
Just couldn't get that bank high enough out to add pressure to Russo's strike. But threats of their own now.
Sanaforth's corner, easily cleared at the near post. McLaughlin onto Rachel Daly. Free kick.
Yeah, it was handball, easy one. Amy Fern, the wrong side of the player, but could still see that that was handball. Good hold-up play from Rachel Daly. She's going to get clattered every single game, Rachel Daly, if she plays that lone striker role in the nine, often with her back to the player to shield the ball. She does it so well. Could there be one twist in this game?
Still just under 6 minutes of stoppage time to go. Staniforth. Oh, that looks close.
It's that far out that I would have backed Zinsberger to save that, but Lucy Staniforth with only two in the wall. That's Zinsberger saying, go on, have a go. Because she thought she could have a direct strike. Normally you'd put four or five in a wall, so.
And it's Villa's turn to throw on the forwards, Alicia Lehmann and Adriana Leon. On to try and salvage something from Aston Villa. Is Ebony Salmon going to bulldoze her way through a couple of Arsenal players? Pullover works the space, and maybe held on to it for a little too long. Here's Jordan Nobbs. Leon. Amy Fern happy with that challenge. Mead onto Blackstenius.
Arsenal have somehow got themselves out of this rut, not just this game against Villa, but the start of their entire season. And she has been instrumental in that. Her character, the fact that she's played in three different positions today. A never say die attitude, a yellow card, is standard, and that's why today Katie McCabe, the epitome of a fight back, is my Barclays player of the match.
And as for Villa, it's a familiar tale for them. Only Spurs dropped more points from winning positions last season in the WSL, and it has happened again. They did it on the opening day. They did go down to 10. And Carla Ward might be feeling, could they have done more? Could they have been slightly more positive as Arsenal kept pushing and pushing forward? Blackstenius over the top towards Pullover.
Yes, because a lot of pressure has come on Rachel Corsi, Danielle Turner and Anna Patton, who have been fabulous for such a huge amount of this game, soaked so much pressure, put their bodies on the line. Rachel Corsi has been an excellent leader, so much for Carla Wood to be proud of for her team, but that so far has not culminated in points on the board.
Heading for a third straight loss to start the new season. Blacksinius. Mead making her way forward. She'll leave it here for the Cass. Lehman draws the foul. Mon will get a Mead goal, but she's set up potentially the winner with a great bit of vision. Knew exactly where Russo was.
An assist already for Beth Mead. And fledgling minutes back from recovery from that ACL injury. And a massive, massive well done. I've been through ACL reconstructions. It's an awful dark place, mentally, physically. And if you get back to full fitness, to back to full performance, I know what you've been through, and plaudits to Beth Mead and the team around her, but for her mental and physical strength she's shown. It's great to have her back.
A few more to come with that exact same injury in women's football, but particularly at Arsenal. Leah Williamson, who we heard from at half-time, and Vivian Miedemar, Laura Wienreuter as well. Ford. Blacksinius, brilliant block, and Beth Mead can't get on the rebound. It's Lucy Parker on the line.
Another player we talked centrally has been outstanding today, Lucy Parker. Everywhere, when the centre-halves have committed, she's been in behind. Just took a knock on the eye, but look at this positioning. She recognises the danger where the centre-halves have to commit, and she gets in behind her goalkeeper. Beautiful play from Caitlin Ford, and that's the cutback that I've not seen at all today. That's picked out a player rather than a hopeful ball into an area for Arsenal. It should really have extended Arsenal's lead.
The 12 minutes have elapsed.
Oh, Rachel Corsi, captain for today, will be disappointed with the result, but should be delighted with everything else, although, as a player, that is zero consolation. You want a scrappy, undeserved point.
Ebony Salmon through on goal. And Lotta Wibben-Moy celebrates that like she scored the winner.
Fantastic. Arsenal from day one, Lotta Wibben-Moy. And as Ebony Salmon pounced on that through ball, thought she was going to take the smile off the Arsenal fans' faces.
Still we play on. McKay. Blacksinius, flag goes up.
Offside, not full time.
Not the whistle that the fans wanted to hear.
Tell you what, the Aston Villa away fans in that far corner have been excellent. Been watching, and we're seeing that grow, aren't we? Away fans.
All over. 3 points for Arsenal, but this means so much more. Their first win of the season. They faced adversity. They've had to come from a goal down. They kept going. They kept their belief. And eventually they came out with the win. And a long-awaited first WSL goal for Alessia Russo after Katie McCabe got the equaliser that some thought was never going to come. Return of Beth Mead also a huge boost for Arsenal, who are up and running. As for Aston Villa, three games against tough opposition and they have no points to show for it. And again, they can't hold on to a lead. Positives to take, but no points after three rounds of fixtures. A huge victory for Arsenal. Full time at the Emirates. Arsenal 2, Aston Villa 1.
Thank you, Robin. A very noisy, happy Emirates Stadium. Seeing Beth Mead finally return to the pitch right there. And what a reception she is getting. Anita Asante, they found a way back in this game to claim their first 3 points of the season. They finally get a win.
Well, you know, in the end, the energy, you can feel it in the crowd. But Beth Mead had impact. The super sub came in, made a difference. So did Blackstenius as well. And I think, you know, we saw the quality when they, in the final third, when they are clinical, when they're arriving into space, as opposed to waiting for the ball to enter the areas of the box.
Yeah, I think the subs changed the game for me. I think Arsenal subs were brilliant. They've come on, they brought energy. They weren't static. We was talking throughout the whole game, me and Neats, about Arsenal's movement and that they was already in there, but the subs changed the game for me.
They really did. Serena Wiegmann right there will be happy of the return of Beth Mead, Anita.
Absolutely, and so are the Arsenal fans. You can just see the reaction to her being back on the pitch and what a lift that is for the team and for the supporters. We know what she can do. She's already shown again just how impactful she is to this team.
Do you think this will ignite their season now, Gilly?
Yeah, and that's what I said at half-time. It don't matter if they win this game 2-1. All right, the performance wasn't... I mean, the last 10 minutes, I think that was the best 10 minutes in the game. But it is. They just needed that result. They need that pressure to get that first win and the points on the ball.
OK, well, let's see how they did it. Let's look at the goals, Anita. They finally managed to break down a stubborn Aston Villa.
Yeah, like you said, you know, lots of credit to the Aston Villa defence, but here... ball carrying, you see Katie McCabe's arriving on the overlap to then come in, and what a fantastic finish that is. No goalkeeper is stopping that, Judy.
No, and what we said is, in the first half, the Arsenal players were already there when the ball arrived, but you're looking at how late McCabe comes. No defender's got any chance to come out and close that down, but you do not stop those strikes as a goalkeeper.
Yeah. Especially from Katie McCabe, you know, they're always screamers, and that definitely was one.
Katie McCabe on her 200th appearance for the club in the WSL, and a new contract, Anita, for Katie.
Well, she'll be buzzing, you know, she's just proving her worth and her value, constantly adding with goals, and, you know, she's a leader, we know that. She brings energy, she fights for every ball, and she's a massive player for this club.
Yeah, one of the most experienced players that Arsenal actually have now, Gilly. Let's look at the second goal, her first goal for her new club. Alessia Russo.
Yeah, and again, it brings that pressure off of her. But you're looking at Mead as well. She wants the ball. She's demanding the ball. It's just that link-up play. Here, she cushions it. It's a perfect set that Russo can hit that first time. She doesn't hit it too hard, that Alessia has to take the touch. She cushions it. I do think the goalkeeper should have done better there as well. But I think the power behind the ball from Russo, yeah, it's a great goal.
Yeah, and it's just the opposite movement for, you know, Mead to just pull off, give herself that bit of space. And she's a ball carrier, and that's what you need, someone who's just going to commit defender, and suddenly the pocket opened up for Russo to take that on.
I love how you're analysing Alessia's goal, and she joins us right now beside us. How does it feel, Alessia, to get your first goal for the club?
Oh, absolutely buzzing. First goal, but also the win, and here in front of the fans, I think we really needed them today. And they came out, they come out in full force every time, so... it's tough, this league's tough. You've got to dig deep to get results. And yeah, we definitely did that today.
Yeah, I was going to say, Aston Villa really stubborn, but you managed to keep going and going and finally break them down.
Yeah, for sure. I think, yeah, we were resilient. I think we had to be. But I think we all knew as a team that moments and chances would come and we just had to take them. So yeah, we dug deep and got there in the end.
How does it feel to have Beth Mead back on the pitch as well?
Oh, absolutely buzzing. I think... you can see by her reception here today is exactly how we feel as players. She's a top talent, and yeah, It's exactly what you want coming back. She's so exciting and I can't wait to play with her.
How do you feel? Do you feel this will actually start the season now for Arsenal after your slow start?
Yeah, for sure. I think we've had a bit of a tough start. But that's football. We've got to bounce back. We've been working really hard as a team. And I think that, yeah, we needed this today. We needed a performance like we put on. We needed to dig deep and, got the 3 points.
Alessia, congratulations on the goal today.
Thank you.
Of course, we know that you're brilliant at hold-up play and stretching the game as well, but what's your preferred role? Do you like playing wide of the front three or in the centre of the front three?
I just like to be on the ball. I don't mind too much where it is, but, yeah, I just try and get on the ball. And try and create. I mean, I like to run in behind, but I also like to have the ball at my feet. So, yeah, just create and try and get in and around the goal as much as possible.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah, and Alyssa, how are you settling in at Arsenal as well? So you're getting to work with the likes of Kelly Smith. How do you feel that's improved your game too?
Massively, the likes of learning off Kelly, but also playing with amazing players every day. And yeah, you've got to come into the team really quickly and pick up things because there's not much time, especially after the World Cup. So you're learning things every day, you're picking up little new connections, but it's exciting, it's nice to be in and around it all.
Alessia, thank you for joining us. We'll let you go and join in the celebrations.
Thank you.
Proud of loving it.
Well done. Thank you
so much. A huge player and a huge asset to Arsenal, and it has taken time for her to gel in for the club, Anita, so that goal will be massive for her.
I think it's a big confidence boost for any striker, especially Alessia, you know, with all the expectation coming into the team. But I think you can see she's so mature, she takes it in her stride, and she's got the right mentality to just focus and keep working hard.
Yeah, she really has. And just a word on Aston Villa, because they'll be disappointed, Jilly.
Yeah, I think they'll be devastated, you know, because I think they defended really well for majority of the game, but you can just tell with the substitutions, and Villa were tired, and Arsenal just had that energy that they just couldn't match, but they just got to pick themselves up again and take that performance into the next game.
What is it, Anita, when you look at the Aston Villa side? Why are they not clicking at the moment?
Oh, I think it's tough. You know, you're missing, like we said, Kenza Dali and Hansen, and they're big, big players for them, especially in the attacking third. But today it was, you know, difficult. Towards the end of the game, Arsenal had the squad depth as well to come up, bring players off the bench and really make an impact.
Yeah, they've got a huge game next week taking on Tottenham.
Massive game again. They'll definitely want to get a result there, but they'll take the positives from today and try and implement that and improve on this performance.
Okay. Well, thank you both for joining me here at the Emirates. A happy Emirates Stadium. We're going to be at another Premier League ground next weekend, the King Power Stadium, as Leicester will be taking on Manchester City. Do join us then. Thank you very much.
The pressure mounting. You can smell the jeopardy in the air in North London.